Good afternoon, everybody, and Happy New Year. I welcome you this afternoon to the inauguration of John McCormick as our mayor and the reorganization of the Municipal Council and their meeting, January 1st, 2024. Notice requirements of the Open Public Meeting Law have been satisfied concerning this meeting. The Home News Tribune and the Star Ledger published a notice on October 6, 2023. Should be so noted in the minutes of this meeting, and it was also posted on the Municipal Bulletin Board. At this time, I'd like to call up John Eberhardt, retired Navy, for the presentation of the colors. Mr. Eberhardt.
Young Marines Post. Young Marines, post colors. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for this Pledge of Allegiance, followed by the National Anthem. We use a chest salute. Unless you're a veteran, then you're certainly welcome to a hand salute. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, liberty, and justice for all. Dismissed.
Let's also give another round of applause to the Woodbridge Community Choir and High School under the leadership of Lisa Romero, the choral director. If you please remain standing, I'd like to call up Reverend John Barbella, the pastor of St. John Vianney Church, the Mayor's Church in Colonia.
Let us pray. Almighty God, as this new year dawns, we thank you for all the good accomplished in our town in the past year and look forward to still greater things. We ask that you open our minds and our hearts to your will and give all those inaugurated today in each of us a great commitment to the common good and to the cause of peace. Amen.
Thank you, Father. Please be seated. Roll call, please. Councilman Bauer.
Here.
Councilwoman De Jesus.
Here.
Councilman Ficarra.
Here.
Councilwoman McAuliffe.
Here.
Councilwoman Meehan.
Here.
Councilman Patel.
Here.
Councilman Small.
Here.
Councilman Spiller.
Here.
And Councilman Anderson.
Here.
It's my pleasure to now introduce to you the Speaker of the State Assembly of New Jersey, Craig Coughlin.
Thank you, John. Good afternoon, everybody. Happy New Year. Let me first start by congratulating Greg Ficarra and Lizbeth De Jesus, our soon-to-be Council President Kyle Anderson and Brian Small on their great victory this past November. Congratulations. Thank you all for all that you do. You are part of the best team around, and it is a privilege to serve with you and get to work with you each and every day, as I have for a while. Now, my job here today is to swear in John McCormick, but I'm going to take what we call in Trenton a point of personal privilege, and I'm going to talk to you for an hour or so about John. Maybe not an hour, but I am going to talk to you about John. You know, I first met John about 30 years ago when a dear friend of his, somebody he grew up with in the terrace, a guy named Kevin Cavanaugh, worked at an armored car company, and I happened to work with him. And we started a fantasy football league. Well, we were looking for an extra person to participate, and Kevin brought in John, and that's where we first met. Now, he quickly recognized that he didn't have the requisite skills to continue in the league, and so he quit the first year. He will tell you that he was driven out by some bad deal. But from that point on, John McCormick has been one of my dear friends. I have seen him over the course of these 30 years grow and develop as a mayor. He is one of my closest and dearest friends. We talk about things great and small. We talk about personal lives. We talk about dreams and aspirations. And it's a truly terrific friendship that is enduring and special. And because of that, I've had a front row seat watching all that John McCormick has done as the mayor. Now, those of us who know him know that he's outsized, that he's funny, that he is passionate about his commitment to the community. We know, though, he's a regular guy, a guy who this month can't wait to become a grandfather. Let's hear it for that. A regular guy who loves sports and loves a good Miller Genuine 64. Now, if you think it's Miller Lite, the beer of choice anymore, you're not hanging around with him enough. You got to start spending more time with him. And over the course of the time, I've watched him grow, and I've seen the things that he has done for this township. It has truly, truly been remarkable. And he continues to find ways to make the township grow and develop. And he's adaptive. I don't think that John himself thought that when he took office that he was going to be an arts guy, and he is. I don't think he was going to saw himself an environmentalist, and yet Woodbridge every year wins the award for being the most sustainable community in the state. In fact, we win by so much that we actually took a year off just to let somebody else have a chance so that there would be somebody to beat next year, because if they all gave up, what would we do? The people of Woodbridge know John as a guy who gets things done, who makes sure that the things run on time, that the parks are clean and that they're new, that they're ever-growing and expanding, that the recreational opportunities and the senior opportunities and the opportunities for kids are there all the time and continuing to grow and develop. They also see the fact that he's he puts his great talent to work, making sure that the city's financial, the township's financial circumstances are always getting better. He works with the Board of Ed in a way that few communities do in this state. And he's built an incredible team sitting behind me of people who are remarkable in their own talent and who work together to make Woodbridge the envy of the state. Truly, I get to talk to people all the time and they say things like, if there were only more places that work like Woodbridge. People who want to come and grow a business here or move into and develop homes and or move here understand how incredibly fortunate Woodbridge is to have a team that makes sure things get happen. And we have all seen that time and time again. Now, the people of Woodbridge have recognized that, and so for the fifth time this year, they elected John McCormick to be his mayor. That's an applause line. There have been 23 men and women who have had the privilege of serving as the mayor of Woodbridge Township. The longest serving mayor is a fellow named August Greiner. He served from 1934 to 1951. He's the number one, the longest serving mayor in history, but not for long. Because next year, about this time, John McCormick will become the longest serving mayor in the history of the city, the township of Woodbridge. And while I'm 100% biased, I dare to say the best to ever do it. It is my privilege now to swear in an extraordinary leader, a very dear friend, and a great man, my friend John McCormick. John.
John, get this. Repeat after me. I, John E. McCormick.
I, John E. McCormick.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of New Jersey.
And the Constitution of the State of New Jersey.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
And to the governments established.
And to the governments established.
In the United States and in this state.
In the United States and in this state.
Under the authority of the people.
Under the authority of the people.
And that I will faithfully.
And that I will faithfully.
Impartially, and justly enforce all laws,
and justly enforce all laws,
and perform all the duties of the office of mayor,
and perform all the duties of the office of mayor,
according to the best of my ability,
according to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Mayor John McCormick.
This is John McCormick, and I approve Craig's message. Thank you very much, and Happy New Year to all. Thank you to Father John Barbella, the new pastor of my hometown parish, St. John Vianney in Colonia. You have followed in the footsteps of Monsignor O'Neill and Father Gloss in performing the invocation and benediction, and it is truly appreciated. Thank you to my sister Anne Marie for holding the Bible for the swearing-in ceremony. Normally, my wife and daughter would be up here, but my wife Tammy is visiting my daughter Erin in Colorado and helping her get ready for the birth of our first grandchild, Matthew Kimmeth, who is scheduled to be born in 24 days, and we cannot wait. I know they're watching on Facebook Live, and we're joined here by my mother and future great-grandmother, Mary, with my sister Maureen, brother Tommy, brother-in-law John, nephew Philip, and his girlfriend Lacey, and I thank you all for attending. It's a great honor to be sworn in by my very good friend Craig Coughlin, our 19th District Assemblyman. We go way back to the late 1980s, prior to either of us being involved in Woodbridge government, and we have enjoyed a terrific relationship as we both serve the residents of Woodbridge Township. On January 9th, Craig will be sworn into his eighth term as our Assemblyman, and he will set a New Jersey state record by being named the Assembly Speaker by his peers for a fourth straight term. Our State of the Township address, which we will present next month, is the time to discuss accomplishments of the past year and the future vision of the coming years. Our inauguration address on January 1st every 4 years is a time to thank all the township employees, board members, community leaders, volunteers, and residents who created a track record that allowed our team to once again achieve an overwhelming victory on Election Day. Joining Craig on our team is State Senator Joe Vitale, who is now entering his 27th year serving the 19th District, and Assemblywoman Yvonne Lopez, who is entering her 7th. Our Middlesex County officials, led by Director Ron Rios and featuring our very own Charlie Kenny, have joined with our state legislative team to literally provide tens of millions of dollars in state and county grants to Woodbridge over the past decade. Joining us from the county is Edison's Charlie Tamaro, Sheriff Millie Scott, and Commissioner Chanel Scott McCollum. Thank you for being here. Congressman Frank Pallone is in the top 1% of seniority in the United States House of Representatives and has been a tremendous resource when we or our residents need help with federal government issues. Unfortunately, Congressman Pallone could not be here today, but he deserves our gratitude, so thank you, Congressman. The most important team to any mayor, though, is the local governing body, our Township Council. Four of them, Brian Small, Greg Ficarra, Lizbeth DeJesus, and Kyle Anderson, just spent many months on the campaign trail together after spending the last two terms representing the township, and we are looking forward very much to the next 4 years. Congratulations to all four of you for also being sworn in this afternoon, and special congratulations to Kyle Anderson, who in a few short minutes will be sworn into his second term as Woodbridge Township Council President. Before long, we will be working to re-elect our terrific ward council persons, Sharon McAuliffe in the first, Howie Bauer in the second, Corey Spiller in the third, Veeru Patel in the fourth, and Debbie Mean in the fifth. No matter whose name is out there on the ballot, the 10 of us work extremely hard to keep our team intact and keep Woodbridge moving forward. Unlike many, if not most, other municipalities, we have a very functional government. We all get along, we work together, we socialize together, we know each other's families, and most importantly, we communicate. We do not always agree on every issue, but we keep our discussions professional, and we all work together for the good of the residents of Woodbridge Township. We also have stability and continuity on the town council that other towns lack, as our team averages nearly 10 years of service, led by Greg Ficarra with 17 and Kyle with 12. Thank you to each and every one of you. We're sure you've heard us say that Woodbridge is the best town around once or twice over the past several years. That can only be true if Woodbridge has the best team around, and we absolutely positively do. No town that we have ever seen has the quality and caliber of our senior management team, the department and division heads, and the rank and file employees of the Township of Woodbridge. The first person hired on our team many years ago was Carolyn Ehrlich, my best friend of 27 years, who was on the town council in the 90s, when, as chief financial officer, we teamed up for 2 years on the community playground project in Merrill Park and have not stopped working together ever since. Not only is Carol our chief of staff, but more importantly, she serves as the head of our redevelopment agency that handles all of the economic development projects for Woodbridge. Businesses know how easy it is to do business here because of the efforts of Carolyn and her deputy, Heather LaMotta, and we appreciate you both for advancing our outstanding business environment. Another former councilman on our senior management team is John Mitch, who was on the council since 1989 and who joined the executive branch several years later to become the deputy municipal clerk and then clerk, and he even served a 2-year stint as business administrator. Very few people in the state have that combination of positions on their resume, and that makes John an invaluable contributor to the success of our team. John has lived here all his life, and it is very rare when John does not know someone in town and where they live and where they work and who their family members are. He thinks of things that many of us do not, and his advice and insight is invaluable as we deal with all the issues facing our township. The third guy named John on our senior management team is John Haggerty, who we met back in 2002 while working in the State Treasury Department. During those 4 years, he handled communications for the Attorney General's Office and the Department of Environmental Protection. We saw him in action in Trenton on some joint issues and saw his calm demeanor and outstanding writing skills and communication abilities. And when the time came to hire a communications director for the township, he was our first and only choice. John has outstanding relationships with the local and statewide media, and we have had no shortage of issues with national significance over the years that John has handled flawlessly. Together with his team of Megan Cushba and Kelly with an IE Walsh, they have put together press releases, brochures, pamphlets, flyers, and our outstanding Woodbridge News, and have overseen our great TV 35 operation under the guidance of Gina Forbes and Joe Fernandez to keep our residents informed of all of our great programs, services, and events. They also run our township website and social media pages that are outstanding. Thank you, Hags, Cush, and IE. The last member of our senior management team is the longest tenured one with Woodbridge Township, business administrator Vito Simaluca, who started his career part-time in the police department before becoming full-time in the Department of Public Works, the two biggest departments of town in town. Not many BAs in the state have experience in police and DPW. Vito truly worked his way up from bottom to the top and is an inspiration to all of the employees in the township who know there's a path to upward mobility for doing a great job. His first management position was running our community center ice rink, and then the community center overall, and then the entire recreation department before becoming BA in January of 2020. Together with Casey Wagner, our deputy business administrator, they handle the day-to-day nuts and bolts of running the town, so I don't have to. It's much more fun to read the kids in the classroom or go to a senior center luncheon than handle contract negotiations or deal with personnel issues. The department that most residents of Woodbridge are impacted by every day is naturally Public Works, which visits each resident twice a week for trash and recycling pickups. People see them for road and sewer repairs and see clean and safe buildings and schools and parks when they visit them. Most importantly, they see them working diligently during snowstorms when Woodbridge streets are cleaned quicker and better than any town around us. George Brew is the director of Public Works, and Bobby Higgins is his deputy, and they are lifetime employees of Woodbridge Township after starting their careers as laborers. They know the ins and outs of every aspect of Public Works. The department that nobody wants to see unless they need them is our police department. The Woodbridge PD is the best in the state, and not because we say so, but because they are nationally recognized every 3 years by an independent team of experts from the Commission on the Accreditation of Law Enforcement Agencies, who perform a rigorous examination of their policies, practices, and procedures, and they pass with flying colors every time. Like Public Works, the police department is led by two career employees, former police officers, Director Bob Hubner and Deputy Director Joe Niski, who both started as rookie patrolmen, and also by recently named Chief Law Enforcement Officer Brian Murphy. These leaders have the respect of their police force and civilian employees, along with the respect of other law enforcement agencies and judicial branches of government throughout our county and state. Our police department also handles emergency management, which is headed by Patrick Kenny. We as elected officials can sleep safely and soundly at night during a storm because Pat Kenny does not. Our health department, led by Director Phil Bajowski and Chief Health Officer David Kolodzinski, toiled in relative obscurity for years, running health clinics, senior centers, and our animal shelter, until COVID changed all of that nearly 4 years ago and highlighted a team that is unrivaled in the state. We were the only town in the county and among the very few in the state that handled our own vaccine clinics. Our doctors and nurses and staff delivered thousands of doses to our residents, including to our homebound senior and disabled populations, and to children while putting them at ease by wearing superhero costumes. They provided the information for our daily and now weekly calls to our residents with a joke thrown in that perhaps made you smile, but more likely made you frown. Our recreation department just keeps getting bigger and bigger with more and more responsibilities and opportunities for our residents under the direction of Director Brian Molnar and Deputy Director Paul Losick and Accountant Patrick Muller. In the last several years, they added the club at Woodbridge, the Cypress Rec Center, the Acacia Center and Youth Center, Highland Grove Youth Center, and Springwood Swim Club, many of which were run by Special Projects Manager Chris Costi. The rec department this year will have more summer concerts and music and plays and sports leagues for our children than ever before. Our Avenel Performing Arts Center and Curtin's Restaurant are getting back to pre-COVID numbers under the direction of Anthony Wilkinson, and 2024 promises to be the best year ever. Our hidden treasure, the Barron Arts Center, has a jam-packed schedule of 2024 events under the leadership of Cynthia Knight. Our planning director, Marta Levski, also helps to bring new companies to Woodbridge and help our current businesses expand, and runs the planning department on a day-to-day basis, processing thousands of permits for new construction and handling the planning and zoning boards plus the inspection process flawlessly. Tony Tortorello, Greg Zock, and Kimberly Mihalix oversee a team of inspectors who don't just point out flaws in plans or construction, but suggest ways to fix and improve things. Let's wish the best of luck to their former leader, Tommy Kelly, who retired today after 35 years of service as our main building inspector. Mike Gellin runs a professional engineering division that is full of qualified individuals like Bas Patel and Tom Flynn that minimize the help we need from outside consultants. They are talented in every aspect of engineering, from road and sewer construction to flood management to park and field design. I get to throw dirt with a shovel at a groundbreaking and cut a ribbon at a grand opening, but in between, Marta, Carol, and Heather join with planning and engineering with inspectors to form a team that helps every new company in town every step of the way, from project introduction to permitting to final certificate of occupancy. Our Department of Senior Services was formed a few years ago to consolidate the Office on Aging, our 6 senior centers, and the dozen buses in our senior transportation service in one place under the direction of Director Michelle Morgan, and it has paid off tremendously. It is very safe to say that no town around offers more to their senior citizens than Woodbridge Township. Our business administrator also directly supervises the Department of Administration and Finance, which includes Tax Collector Rich Lorenzen, Tax Assessor Rich Duda, Chief Financial Officer Manny Fernandez, along with Deputy Mike Klepchik and Accountant Katie Mullen, Purchasing Agent Jen Burns, Human Resources Director Darren Crocker, and Information Technology Director Scott Kuzma, who all work behind the scenes to keep the infrastructure of our town running. You probably know of our superb library system under the direction of Monica Ebinger, and hopefully you do not have too much interaction with our municipal court under Phil DiNicola. John Mitch's clerk's office with Deputy Clerk Cheryl Sharkey handles all of the township documents and records and is the place to go for all licenses and permits. Special thanks to our law department under the direction of Jim Nolan, Craig Coughlin, and Eric Lang, and thank you to our paralegal, Eric Aber. Last but certainly not least are the spectacular employees in the mayor's office who handle constituent calls and visits from residents and who keep us all running on time by handling our busy schedules. Pam Lukes, Nicolette Dunn, Loretta Dowd, and Jerry Mazurek are the glue behind our senior management team, and they make us look good every single day of the week. You heard a lot of names here of the leaders of our township government, but there are over 1,000 other individuals responsible for Woodbridge having the best programs and services around. Our rank and file employees do their job every day without fanfare, but they do need to know that we appreciate them. We are not exaggerating when we say we get 10 times as many compliments as complaints from our residents and businesses about their everyday performance. We would like to thank and recognize our colleagues in public service on the Woodbridge Board of Education. Congratulations to Frank Della Pietro, Marie Anderson, and newcomer Nizam Muhammad on your election to the board. And thank you to Sue Borden, Jenny Perez, John Treewasser, Joe Velez, AJ Sedana, and Dan Harris for your continued service to the board. A special thank you to Brian Molnar, who retired from the board after 18 years of dedicated service. Thank you, Brian. Dr. Joe Massimino is the outstanding superintendent of our school district and is ably assisted by Brian Wolferman, Dr. Maria Giancarelli, Paul Pastorino, Julie Baer, and Patricia Fitzgerald on his senior management team. Like the township, he has an amazing group of leaders with a lifetime of employment in the education field, and it shows in their performance leading our district. We work directly with our school district, unlike just about any town around, and we see firsthand their experience and dedication and commitment to their staff and students. We are also frequent visitors to schools, and we see the same from our thousands of teachers and staff members and administrators. It's not just the people employed by the township or school district who work hard for our residents, however. Today, we would like to pay special tribute to the dozens of residents who volunteer on our boards and commissions. These individuals work without compensation, but spend several hours per month attending meetings and reading agendas and researching issues. Many people here were appointed or reappointed to various boards today, but we would like to give special mention to anyone who has served in a volunteer board capacity for more than 10 years. Please stand when your name is called, and please hold your applause to the end. On our planning board, we have Chairman Ray Miller, Terry Sharkey, and Phil Bajowski. Our zoning board has Donna Zielinski and Deepak Thacker. On the Environmental Commission, we have Danny Charles Estain and Chantel Greffer, and our Cable Commission has Bruno Martins and Corey Spiller. Our Cultural Arts Commission has Connie Ellick, Antonia Pancel, Bernadette Soler, Dolores Caprara Joffrey, and Jeff Cohen. And our Historic Preservation Commission has Audrey LaPenta, Courtney Lowry, Bruce Christensen, Miguel Martin, Dan D'Arcy, and once again, Dolores Caprara Joffrey. Our Veterans Alliance has John Eberhardt, and our Community Emergency Response Team has Brian Austin. Our Housing Authority has Jack Kenny and Greg Ficarra, and our Library Board has Fred Silbon, Isha Vaez, Anthony Terabetsky, and Carol Eberhardt. Our Main Street Special Improvement District has Leon Schwartz, and our Oak Tree Road Special Improvements District has Mahesh Shah. The Redevelopment Agency has Bob Gillespie, Hank Heidacker, and John Err, and the Rent Leveling Board has John Martin. Thank you all for your long-term commitment and service to Woodbridge Township. Special mention goes to our longtime Mayor's Advisory Committee, led by Chairman Terry Sharkey, who was appointed to his post way back in 1999. The list of volunteers on the MAC with over 10 years of service is long and includes Peggy Sharkey, Sheila and Bob Carroza, Laura Supp, Larry Merowitz, Mike Ilions, Barbara Stewart, Jess Florick, Derek Supp, Stella Pertek Blonde, Dwight Glenn, Sharon Alashri, Roncia Hutchinson, Dan Harris, Frank St. Marie, Robin Kaplan, Anthony Pepe, Amy McDevitt, Anil Muhammad, Marty Genzer, Jeff Michael, Rob Sierra, Don Larson, Mohammed Misbahadin, and Nicole Danella, and many of them are here working today and volunteering. Thank you to the MAC. In the fall campaign, we were asked what the biggest issues would be in Woodbridge Township over the next 4 years. The best answer to that question is that we just don't know. On January 1st, 2020, when we were all on this stage, we had no idea what the next 4 years would bring. We lived through Superstorm Sandy, but who knew Hurricane Ida would be nearly as bad and force many township residents from their homes? Who knew there would be a cancer scare that thankfully proved to be nothing to worry about, but which still took a monumental effort by our school district, township, county, state, and federal officials to manage? Who could have predicted the COVID pandemic, which turned our world upside down? But our township government stayed open for business while others were shutting down even basic services. We once again on January 1st, 2024, have no idea what the next 4 years will bring. But we certainly know that we are uniquely well equipped as a local government to handle anything that comes our way. Our managers and employees are well educated, well trained, and highly experienced to deal with the expected as well as the unexpected. There is no better group running local government anywhere in the state of New Jersey. Now it gives me great pleasure to introduce the dais to you, the people mentioned already in this address, so please stand up for a second or two when called. I will go in reverse order of their years of service to Woodbridge Township, and please hold your applause to the end. First, the rookies. Personnel Director Darren Crocker has 5 years of service. Library Director Monica Eppinger and Township Engineer Mike Gellin both have 7. Deputy Business Administrator Casey Wagner has 8. Deputy Redevelopment Director Heather LaMotta has 9. Special Projects Manager Chris Costi has 10. Assistant CFO Mike Klepczyk has 11 years and is representing CFO Manny Fernandez, who has 12. Purchasing Agent Jen Burns has 16. She started here when she was 10. Communications Director John Haggerty has 17. Municipal Attorney Jim Nolan has 20. Barron Arts Center Head Cynthia Knight and Senior Services Coordinator Michelle Morgan have 21. Chief of Staff Carol Ehrlich has 28. Tax Assessor Rich Duda has 29. Tax Collector Rich Lorenzen has 31. Information Technology Director and former Chief Law Enforcement Officer Scott Kuzma has 33. Municipal Clerk John Mitch has 34. Public Works Director has 35. And so does Planning Director Marta Levski-Darden. Deputy Police Director Joe Niski has 38. And so does Emergency Management Coordinator Pat Kenny. Now it gets really serious. Recreation Director Brian Molnar has 40 years with Woodbridge Township. So does Councilman Brian Small, who started in Public Works, then served 23 years as a Woodbridge police officer before retiring to run our first aid operation before retiring again to become a councilman. Business Administrator Vito Simuluka has exactly 41 years as of today. Health Director Phil Bajowski has 4 more days than Vito. And Police Director Bob Hubner just started his 43rd year. There are also many employees not on the stage with years of service in the high 30s and low 40s. But nobody can top Municipal Court Director and former Deputy Police Director Phil DiNicola, who last year celebrated working for Woodbridge Township for 51 consecutive years. To all of our department and division heads, thank you once again for your constant support, encouragement, and cooperation, and for your amazing leadership skills. With teammates like all of you, how can we not be successful every other November? Thank you again to the more than 1,200 full-time and hundreds of part-time employees who work tirelessly to serve the 103,000 residents of this great township of Woodbridge. All of us get to be up on stage and on TV today, but that's because we can't fit everyone else up here. It is each and every one of you who provide the day-to-day services and programs that our residents have come to know and love. To the general public of Woodbridge, as mayor and speaking on behalf of my teammates on the Township Council, we greatly appreciate the confidence you have shown to us these last several years. You tell us what you like, you tell us what you don't like. You offer criticism and suggestions, but always in a positive way. You encourage us with your words and by your attendance at our functions and events. Your votes prove your ultimate support, and we will never let you down. We are all truly looking forward to 4 more years of running Woodbridge Township to make the best town around even better. Thank you.
As I call up again the Woodbridge Community Choir and High School Choir under the leadership of Beth Amory Teutsch and Lisa Romero, as they make their way up, I want to recognize a number of county commissioners who arrived when we got up here. Mr. Kenny and Ms. McCollum, I see our county clerk is with us, as well as our sheriff.
Keep on. councils jammed with public servants, Lisbeth, Sharon, and Viru. If you have a problem, call Bauer or Small. There's no job that they can't do. Together they can handle your issues. They can care for you from the bottom of their soul. Oh, someday, folks, I don't know when he's gonna get to that place that he really wants to go and relax in the sun. Until then, Johnny Mac, maybe he was born to run. Johnny Mac, maybe he was born to run.
Come on, Woodbridge!
Johnny Mac, maybe he was born to run. Oh, 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 oh.
Thank you. At this time, I'd like to start swearing in the council members who were just re-elected, beginning with Councilman Kyle Anderson. If his family would please join me up on the stage as well. Do you, Kyle Anderson, solemnly swear that you will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of New Jersey, that you will bear faith and allegiance to the same, and to the governments established in the United States and in this state, and to the authority of the people, and you will faithfully, impartially, and justly enforce all the laws and perform all the duties of the office of councilman at large, according to the best of your ability, so help you God.
I will.
Lisbeth De Jesus. Again, if her family can come up, please.
Do you, Lisbeth De Jesus, solemnly swear that you will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of New Jersey, that you will bear faith and allegiance to the same and to the governments established in the United States and in this state under the authority of the people, and you will faithfully, impartially, and justly enforce all the laws and perform all the duties of the office of councilwoman at large according to the best of your ability, so help you God.
I do.
Greg Ficarra.
Do you, Greg Ficarra, solemnly swear to support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of New Jersey, that you will bear faith and allegiance to the same and to the governments established in the United States and in this state under the authority of the people, that you will faithfully, impartially, and justly enforce all the laws and perform all the duties of the office of Councilman at Large, according to the best of your ability, so help you God.
I will.
Brian Small.
Do you, Brian Small, solemnly swear that you will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of New Jersey, you will bear faith and allegiance to the same, and to the governments established in the United States and in this state under the authority of the people, and you will faithfully, impartially, and justly enforce all the laws and perform all the duties of the office of Councilman at Large, according to the best of your ability, so help you God.
Council, at this time, I'd like to call for the nomination of Council President for the year 2024. Do I have any nominations?
Mr. Mitch.
Mr. Ficarra.
It gives me great pleasure to nominate Councilman Kyle Anderson for the Council President position. Kyle has the loving support of his family, wife Denise, children Kyle, Naya, Olivia, Derek, and Brian. He has leadership experience not only here on the council, but also in his professional life, where he serves as Middlesex County Superintendent of Schools and with a number of community-based organizations. He is an advocate for anyone whose voice needs to be heard. He is a caring and supportive member of our council team and truly understands what it takes to be a public servant. It is without any reservation that I nominate Kyle Anderson for Council President.
Thank you, Councilman. Do I have a second?
Yes, Mr. Mitch. I'm honored to second the motion for Kyle Anderson as our next Council President. My association with Kyle spans over two decades. During my time, I've witnessed his dedication to the betterment of Woodbridge. Kyle is a lifelong resident of Woodbridge and has been an integral part of our council since 2011. His tenure on the council not only reflects his deep connection to our community, but also provides him with the invaluable experience necessary to excel in the role of council president. Kyle's commitment to various aspects of our community as a devoted family man, he and his wife Denise have raised five children, which have attended the Woodbridge Township school system. His involvement in coaching youth sports showcases not only his passion for physical well-being, but also his commitment to shaping the next generation of leaders. Kyle also has a strong ties to heritage and community development through his advocacy for preserving cultural roots while actively contributing to the growth and progress of Woodbridge Township. Kyle's actions reflect the leader who understands the delicate balance between tradition and evolution. Please join me in endorsing Kyle for Council President.
Thank you. Are there any other nominations for President? Any other nominations? Congratulations, sir. Mr. Anderson. And his family want to come back up?
Do you, Kyle Anderson, solemnly swear that you will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of New Jersey? You will bear faith and allegiance to the same and to the governments established in the United States and in this state under the authority of the people. You will faithfully, impartially, and justly enforce all the laws and perform all the duties of the Office of Council President according to the best of your ability, so help you God.
I will.
I give you Council President Kyle Anderson.
So many of you may have noticed me up here feverishly writing. I realized I wrote my notes and I didn't bring my readers up here, so I was trying to write bigger. I'll be brief, but I wanted to say good afternoon and Happy New Year to everyone. I first would like to thank Councilman Vaccara and Councilwoman McAuliffe for nominating me as Council President. I would also like to thank my council teammates for their confidence in me and for endorsing me to lead the council in 2024. I would also like to congratulate Mayor McCormick on being sworn in to his fifth term as mayor. Mayor, your leadership is something we all count on. We've supported your vision, and you and your administrative team continue to plan and execute that vision. I look forward to working more closely with you in 2024. I would also like to thank my wife, Denise, and my family for their sacrifices that they have made so that I could be a public servant. Lastly, I would like to thank the citizens of Woodbridge Township, of all whom we represent. Mahatma Gandhi once said, in order to find yourself, you must first lose yourself in the service of others. From the day that I ran as a student council representative, I found joy in serving the public and being a voice in our community. I stand on that with our council and our mayor because I know that is where their hearts are. I want to thank you for the last 11 years for serving as a councilman, and I look forward to the next 4 years and look forward to this next year as serving as council president. Thank you.
And council, at this time, I'd seek nominations for the office of vice president.
Mr. Mitch.
Mr. Small.
I go back with this gentleman over 30 years. We met in fire services. We've become great friends. He resides in Avenel with his wife, Erin, their children, Elizabeth, Emily, Connor, AKA Bubba. He is truly dedicated to our community, and it's an honor and a privilege to nominate Corey Spiller for vice president.
Thank you. Do I have a second?
Mr. Mitch.
Mrs. Meehan.
I'd like to second the nomination for Councilman Spiller as vice president. I've worked alongside Councilman Spiller for the past 9 years, and he has always been a strong leader for our community, especially the Avenel community. He leads with integrity, compassion, and wisdom, and I know myself, along with my councilmates, welcome him to take the role as vice president.
Thank you. Are there any other nominations? Any other nominations? Mr. Vice President? I give you Vice President Corey Spiller.
Thank you, Mr. Mitch. Like Council President Anderson, you might have seen me scribbling notes because I had a very nice address planned, and it's sitting in my folder in the kitchen. So just work me a little bit. First, I'd like to congratulate the mayor, my fellow councilmates, Councilman Small, Councilwoman Elizabeth DeJesus, Councilman Greg Vaccara, Councilman Kyle Anderson, Council President, on your swearing in today. Second, I'd like to thank my family, Erin, Emily, Elizabeth, Connor, for their support. I'm always thinking family of five. I only have four names. Without you, I couldn't be up here. Finally, I'd like to thank my fellow councilmates for their support, and Councilman Small and Councilwoman Meehan for your nomination. Thank you. I look forward to working with all you under the direction of Council President Anderson. Thank you very much.
This time I'd like to bring the community choir and the high school choir back up, again under the leadership of two wonderful women to our town, Beth Amory Toich and Lisa Romero.
The heartbeat.
Council, there are a couple items we need to get through, if you can, quickly. We have our regular meeting. We're beginning with our resolutions, ordinances, and back to resolutions. With that said, can I get a motion to approve resolutions 1 and 2 that are on your agenda tonight?
Motion.
Second.
Any questions or comments from council? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. You also have first reading ordinances listed before you today. Ordinances listed A through H. Can I get a motion that these ordinances be passed on first reading, published in the Home News Tribune on January 5th, with notice of public hearing be held on January 16th, 2024 at 6 p.m.
Motion.
Excuse me, John Mitch. Mr. Mitch,
yes,
I'm going
Council
to abstain from letter G, please.
So noted. Any other comments? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. If I can, Mr. President, before we go into the agenda, I'm sorry, we have resolutions. I want to finish with numbers 3 through 80. Can I get a motion to approve 3 through 80 by consent?
Motion.
Excuse me, Mr. Mitch. I'd like to abstain from number 76, please.
76, so noted. Any other comments?
I also like to abstain from 67.
So noted. Any other comments? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Mr. President, before we go into the agenda, we do have to provide a public forum at this time. Otherwise, I want to proceed with the meeting, but I'll give an opportunity if anybody has anything in the public to say. Any comments? Here are no comments. Can I get a motion that the public comment portion be closed?
Motion.
Second.
All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Mr. President, if you'll take the agenda from here.
Thank you, Mr. Mitch. We're going to move on. My agenda is in order today. I'm going to move over to Councilman Ficarra.
Thank you very much. I just want to take a moment to thank Maritza and my family for their support and love, especially since I told her in the beginning I was only interested in one or two terms, but we'll let that go. Congratulations to also our colleagues that were elected and reelected, and especially to the quarterback of our team, Mayor John McCormick. And best of luck to President Anderson and Vice President Spiller. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Council President. Sorry, that was from last year. Moving along to Councilman Bauer.
Thank you, Council President. I congratulate the mayor and my fellow at-large councilmates on their swearing in today. Mayor, it all starts with leadership at the top, and that's you. Under your leadership, great things are achieved when a team comes together for a common goal. It's a group of people building trust, working productively, and uniting this community. I quote, alone we can do so little, but together we can do so much. Congratulations. To my councilmates, Kyle and Corey, congratulations on your nomination as council president and council vice president. Kyle, our paths crossed originally when our children were involved in youth sports. We both managed recreational sports programs in this town. Corey had the opportunity to cross paths through the fire service. Both Kyle and Corey have spent the majority of their adult lives giving back to this community through the many organizations they have been part of professionally and as volunteers. Their action as leaders inspires others to do more, learn more, and motivate people to achieve a common goal for the better of our township. Congratulations again, Kyle and Corey. That's all I have. Thank you, Council President. Oh, one more thing. I do wish everyone a healthy, safe, happy New Year. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilman Bauer. Councilman Small.
Thank you, Mr. President. First and foremost, I want to thank my family for being here. Amanda, her husband Joe, their children Jordan and Joseph, my sons Brian and Kyle, and my daughter Brielle. Thank you. To Mayor McCormick and my councilmates, I look forward to working with you and the administration to push Woodbridge Township to its next level. Council President 23, Ficarra, thank you for your leadership and guidance throughout the year. To Council President and Vice President Anderson and Spiller, all the best to you. We'll be there for you all the way. To Mr. Mitch, thank you for always for your guidance and support. To everybody that worked so hard on the campaign to get us reelected, especially Anne Marie, Tish, Erica, Dan, thank you so much. To our police department, public works, fire departments, EMS, all our township employees, thank you for your hard work and dedication. In closing, I'm wishing everyone a happy, healthy, safe New Year. And God bless America. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. Moving along, Councilwoman DeJesus.
Thank you, Council President.
First, I would like to congratulate Mayor McCormick and my fellow councilmates on the re-election campaign. I just have a few words. As Supreme Court Justice Sonia Sotomayor once stated, and I quote, "I am an ordinary person who has been blessed with the extraordinary opportunities and experiences," end quote. Today is one of those experiences. I humbly stand before you this afternoon with a heart full of gratitude for your support in the last 8 years and in your trust for the next 4 years. When we stood here 4 years ago, we went through several challenges that we face and endure as a community and as a country. Going through those challenges made me more steadfast to the oath that I have taken back then and here today. Seeing the resiliency of our community all working together through those challenges is a testament to why Woodbridge is the best town around. My passion is community and service, and I am grateful for the thriving partnerships and friendships that have been formed with several cemented established events like the Backpack and Coat Drives, Women's History, and Hispanic History Month celebrations. I want to thank the mayor, my councilmates, and administration as well for their continued support for my passion. As 2024 is up and running, I look forward to working with you to ensure we as a community continue to make Woodbridge thrive. At this time, I would like to thank Angel and our children, Angel Christian, Matthew, Brianna, and Madison, for their continued support. I would like to acknowledge my little brother, who is an Army and Marine veteran, who is here with me today, along with my sister-in-law, my nephew, and Mama Margie. I also would like to thank Councilman Ficarra for his leadership, full of integrity and empathy for our community. Thank you, and I look forward to working with Council President Anderson and Vice President Spiller this coming year. To our first responders, the best police department around, God bless you all, God bless Woodbridge, and God bless the United States of America. And one last thing, tomorrow is my baby girl's 16th birthday, so I just want to wish Maddie a happy and blessed birthday.
Council Vice President Spiller.
Thank you, Councilman Anderson. My agenda is in order. Once again, I just want to congratulate my fellow councilmates on their swearing in and the mayor, along with the mayor and administration. I look forward to working with the council for the residents. God bless America. Thank you.
Thank you, Council Vice President. And Councilwoman Meehan.
Thank you. My agenda is in order. I would just also like to congratulate all my councilmates and the mayor, and we really are an amazing team together, and I'm so glad that we'll get to work together again. We all have our own little special thing that we all do that makes us really fit together, and we do it for the betterment of the community. Council President Anderson, I know you will do an amazing job as president, and I look forward to working alongside you and you leading us into this new year, and along with Councilman Spiller and Councilman Ficarra, thank you for your steadfast leadership through the past year. It's not easy to be the president, and you did it with grace and integrity, and I appreciate your leadership. And happy, healthy New Year to everybody. That's all I have.
Thank you, Council Meehan. Councilwoman Meehan. Councilman Patel.
Yeah, thank you, Council President. Also, my agenda is also in order. I'd like to actually congratulate you and also our newly nominated Council Vice President, Corey, and our mayor. Congratulations on that elections, and thank you for being there for me and with us. I think we all work together. And to all those out there, I would like to wish you a happy, healthy, and a very prosperous New Year. May God bless you. May God bless America. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilman Patel. Councilwoman McAuliffe.
Thank you, Council President. As everybody else said, going last, there's not much for me to say. I reiterate everything that everybody else said. I want to congratulate the mayor on his winning the election and all of my fellow councilmates who ran. Congratulations, Kyle. Congratulations, Corey. I know that you will do an excellent job in the leadership role of our council. And thank you, Greg Ficarra, for always being there whenever I needed something as a new person on the council. You've guided me all along, as well as Mr. Mitch. Thank you very much. And to all the residents, I want to wish you a very happy, healthy, prosperous, joyful New Year.
Thank you, Councilwoman McAuliffe. Before I pass on to our municipal clerk, I just want to also acknowledge my mom for being here, Jacqueline Anderson. Thank you so much, Mom, for being here on a special day. My sister-in-law, Marie Anderson, and my brother, James, for being here. And I do want to especially thank Councilman Fakara for his leadership and his guidance. He does it, almost makes it seem effortlessly, but his kindness and his willingness to listen to the public, and also his great communication with our mayor and our administration is exemplary, and I want to thank him for his service for 2023. Councilman, Mr. Mitch.
Thank you, Mr. President. My agenda is in order. Congratulations to everyone, and Happy New Year.
All right. Move over to Mayor?
Yes.
Mayor McCormick, have anything to add?
No, thank you. Congratulations, everybody.
Thank you. Okay. We'll go over to our business administrator, Mr. Similuca.
Thank you, Council President. I have one item. First of all, I'd like to congratulate the mayor and the council that were reelected and everyone sworn in today. Look forward to working with you all. I have one item on my resolution for tax and sewer overpayment. Thank you, Council President.
Great. Is Mr. Molnar here? There he is. Recreation.
Probably not my agenda.
Okay. Police Director Hubner.
Thank you, Council President. I have a number of traffic ordinances.
Thank you. And Mr. Bachowski in health?
No resolution items tonight. Thank you, Council President.
Thank you. Planning and development, Mrs. Darden.
Thank you, Council President. Nothing today.
Mr. Brew in public works.
Thank you, Council President. I have one change order, number two, or final for contract 2022-0010.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Brew. And our legal, Mr. Nolan.
Thank you, Council President.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Nothing this afternoon. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Eric.
Thank you, Mr. President. With your approval, I'd like to hold the Board of Health agenda, and I'd like to also call up at this time the community choir and high school choir again.
Fix
I'd like to call Reverend Barbella back up for the benediction.
Let us pray. May the Lord bless and keep each one of us. May he smile upon us and be gracious to us. And in this coming year and always, may he fill us with his peace. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Mayor McCormick, President Anderson, the Municipal Council, I'd like to invite everybody back to the Acacia Center at 95 Port Reading Avenue in Woodbridge for a reception. Mr. President, can I get a motion to adjourn?
Motion.
Any questions or comments? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
So moved. Thank you, everybody.